Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We know the way. Or I know the way, and you're about to see the way if you don't know the way. But this doesn't make sense. Eyes of Truth are right, right, left, right, left. Doesn't really look like that. Because we start off... left. So maybe the sign lies. The eyes are truth, but the sign lies. So we want this one. And then... I just want to get my bearings here. This is where we found the treasure here. And then... Right, we want this one. This was me experimenting with this. And then we want... this one. This one's all the way south. Right, this one. I mean, it is still five, it just doesn't seem like the way. I mean, it tells us to end with left also. Maybe it's reversed? No. And now we're here. So, nothing here, but we have this crest over here. Xiao says, "What's that?" Forte says, "It's Leon's crest. We saw the same crest when we found the resonance stone in the underground of Krenka." "So, Master, how many resonance stones have you collected so far?"
"One."
"We only have the one we found in Krenka, the purification stone." "Well, you still have a long way to go then." Forte says, "What kind of phrase do you think is engraved in the resonance stone we're looking for here?" McBain read the text on the epigraph. Well, that's a new word for me. Epigraph? "Those who have chased the eyes of truth, my gift to you is mind's eye. It reveals hidden enemies." It is one of the only stones that has two words. "Mind's eye, huh?" says Forte. Rachel says, "So where's this treasure anyway?" McBain says, "It's beyond this wall bearing the crest. Knock and it shall be opened." You mean punch? This is not knocking, really. If you call that a knock, then I don't know. Forte and his friends obtain the resonance stone of Mind's Eye. Xiao says, "Hmm, this is it then." Rachel says, "It looks just like any stone, except that it has staff notation engraved on it." Whoa. Yeah, pretty sure that other eye would have just brought us back. Xiao says, "Goodness heavens, what's going on?" "We're back where we started," says Una. "I like your sense of humor, Leon. It was quite fun." McBain says, "I think the melody we just heard is part of Mind's Eye." "Oh, I've got an idea," says Xiao. "I think it will work." McBain says, "You must be up to no good. Don't ever think about making money off resonance stones." "Please, that's not a very nice thing to say. I just thought that we might be able to use this resonance stone as the spice Bruce was talking about." "Aha, right, it could work." See? It's called Mind's Eye, after all. It could help people open their minds. Una says, Uncle Xiao, I like your idea. See? 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 We see. Rachel says, Lin, let's go to Bruce at once. I hope he'll like this, says Una. Oh, just magically teleported back. Okay. I wonder if anyone has anything new to say. Believe me, you better leave this town. Yeah, I think they're all saying the same thing. So let's just go to Bruce. Have you found any good spice? Yes. The sandworms come. Forte says, without the sandworms part, let me hear it then. Oh wait, we don't have it equipped. We're supposed to equip it? That's not that good. What, we like that? Okay. Manager Bruce says, magnificent. It's not as good as the other song. And indeed, open our mind's eyes. Did you like it? Says McBain. Of course. I'll produce a big concert with this piece. I'll promise on the name of Maritos Group. But I may be able to do something with the original score. Well, hopefully you can do something. I mean, it's 3 seconds long. I have an idea. Let me arrange the melodies and make it a quintet piece. Well, the dog can play something. Xiao says, but who's going to arrange it? I am. Actually, I wanted to be a composer. I studied at the music school in Kansas, so I know the basics. Don't you worry. Well, that's reassuring, says McBain. Xiao says, it sounds more fun. Una says, until you finish your arrangement, is there anything I can do to help? Yes, there is. It would be great help if you could go around the town and put up posters for the concert. All right, says Xiao. Let's put up a lot of posters. Xiao receives a poster. Let's go, he says. Oh, he's off, okay. Rachel receives a poster. Leave it to me. Well, I want to see what this stone actually does. I forgot to look. McBain receives a poster. Let's meet again here after we finish putting up the posters. Una receives a poster. I'm going. Forte, let's see who's going to finish first. One? I'm not sure how a dog makes that sound. Forte receives a poster. Please put up posters in places where many people will see them. Is this like a race with her? I don't know. I mean, I don't know if there's an actual race going on or it's just all predetermined. Resonance stones. Okay, Mind's Eye. Resonance stone found in the cave between Trim and Viento reveals invisible monsters. I was right! That phantom thing. I had a feeling we were going to be able to, like, actually deal with that thing. We couldn't actually finish the battle before because we had nothing that would reveal it. Alright, so... okay, he can have 4 stones equipped. Cool. That's a fast drum beat right there. Not this part. Resonance spell. So we got Mind Eyes. A spell cast by the phrase of Mind's Eye identifies one invisible enemy. Funny. Alright, where shall we put a poster? Is it gonna be obvious? What are you doing? We want to put up posters. If you like, please come to our concert. You must be joking. I hate troubadours. Go away. I hate troubadours. Go away. Okay, Ali Sheedy. And Breakfast Club.
Don't put up your poster on my back!
Well, that seems like a good place for it. Well, you'll be a walking advertisement. Troubadours. Yeah, he said that before. Fast beat. Oh, there's those kids. You're prohibited from putting up posters here. Understand?
I don't understand crap.
You can't put up posters here. You guys are no fun. Oh, I didn't realize I can actually walk back through. Have my poster. I would like to glue my poster. I would like something. I'm disappointed, Forte. You haven't finished putting up your posters yet? No, we're talking to everybody. You know how it goes. Are you by yourself? Forte says we're working separately, putting up our posters. Are you giving out a concert? Then we'll definitely come and see you. We'll definitely come and see you. We're looking forward to it. Wow, it's a poster. It has your face on it. We'll be performing. Will you come and see us? Of course. I'll bring Carmi and Lynn with me. We'll definitely be there. Good luck. Oh, not you. This one. What are you carrying? The poster's for our concert. Are you performing? It's so cool. I promise I'll come to see you. I'm looking forward to your performance. I promise I'll come and see you. So, we're still advertising, just with people. Huh? Is that Una? Oh, let's do the exchange while we're here. Didn't come for it, but here we go. I'll go back and talk to her in a bit. I want to put up the posters for our concert. Take my advice and don't waste your time. No one will show up. Well, those three kids are coming. It's no use putting up posters. No one will come. Una says, I'm putting up a poster on the bulletin board. You haven't put up yours yet, Forte. Aha! I won the competition. I guess it is something you could win or lose. Right, we shouldn't get out of the town alone. I don't know what kind of dog sound that is. And not while we're not done putting up the posters, either. Shadow chuckles. Publicity! Publicity! Keep up the good work putting up your posters, Forte! Well, at least he's nicer about it. You want to put up your poster in the tavern? Sorry, but we must keep our reputation. As being a bunch of stodgy people. I better get going and leave the town. But I'm afraid of the swing gang. What are you doing? I wanted to put up posters. You must be kidding. Are you having a concert in this town? I don't think it's a good idea. You should lay low until the swing gang is caught. Negative. Kid, you're still here. You shouldn't walk around in town until the swing gang is caught. Where on earth is a swing gang now? I don't know. We'll be fighting them eventually. I'm not even looking for where to put it up, I'm just talking to everybody. I guess it has something to do with the girl by the barrels. What do you want? We want to put up posters. We're going to have a concert.
A concert? You must be joking.
You must be kidding. No, we're not joking or kidding. Don't scare my wife. Emotionally unstable now, he says. Oh, I talked to her. Okay, I think we talked to everybody. Now we can find out where to actually put this up. Well, we didn't talk to everybody. We talked to everybody except for the one over here. Oh, it's Rachel. Oh, it's you. Forte, what are you doing here? That's my question, Rachel. What are you doing here? Haha, I'm playing hide and seek. Just kidding. I haven't been lazy or anything. Of course not. Lazy is not me. What's a dog doing? No, please! Haha. I like that. Rachel dropped something. What's that? It's a cookie. The narrator, I guess, says. Roof! Your nose is too sharp, says Rachel. What's wrong with it? I have the right to take a rest and eat some cookies. Roof! Cut it out! Forte, do something! Do what? Alright, I can give you some. Roof! He got angry, says Forte. What does he want me to do? Roof! Why don't you give him cookies? Damn. Jan took a poster from Forte's hand. What are you doing? Rachel says, are you telling me to work seriously or something? I guess that's it. I can't believe this. Are you ordering me? Jan stares at Rachel silently. With those doggo eyes. Yes, okay, okay. Rachel receives a poster. I've never seen such a serious dog in my life. This bulletin board already has a poster. There's three of them. Do we still have a poster? The dog gave... Oh, she dropped the poster and the dog gave her back to her. I understand now. Poster, poster. Well, I guess that's not something we can look at in inventory then. Okay. Too bad we can't hang it on the sign. So we came across three bulletin boards. We didn't get our poster. Una says, hey, Forte is back. We have everyone now. I'm ready too. Have you finished your arrangement, says Forte? It's perfect. We didn't get to hang our poster. An original number from the McBain Company entitled Open Your Mind. They received the musical score of Open Your Mind. Forte, your solo is the pillar of this piece. Do you think you can do it? You got me a little nervous. I'll do my best. Let me see, McBain says. Why don't we play it first? Well, you gotta rehearse. At least several times, but we don't have time for that. We need a little thing for the dog to do. Like he can bang his paws on like some kind of drums or bongos or something. Yay, says Xiao. Fantastic. He's still acting like he's in the audience. How was it, Bruce? Says Forte. Was it bad? Says Xiao. It was out of this world. The best I've ever heard. Xiao says, da ha ha ha. I knew it, of course. Don't scare us. Forte, you were great. You did just as I expected, or even better. You'll certainly move the audience with your cithara. I'm sure the concert will be a success. Xiao says, yes, I'm burning. Burning. The McBain Company was ready for their performance. Soon, it was time for the concert. Una says, the curtain will rise soon, Forte. Xiao says, my heart is beating so hard. Rachel says, your heart is beating so hard, right? Are you nervous, Father? I can't help it. No matter how many times I perform, I always tremble before the curtain is up. I hope the audience will gather soon. The manager says, we have a big problem. What's up? You look pale, Bruce, says Xiao. The posters. All the posters in the town were torn up. Well, I guess it doesn't matter we hung those or not. What? Says Rachel. We told the kids. Bruce says, I'm sorry. I didn't think deep enough. People in this town have much stronger resentment towards the swing gang than I thought. Rachel says, but that doesn't give them the right to tear up the posters we spent so much time putting up. Well, you were eating cookies, though. Who did this? I'm so mad, says Xiao. Steam is coming out of my head. I better do something about that. Rachel says, I'll find whoever did this and teach them a lesson. Xiao says, they'll become my punching bag. That's funny. McBain says, Xiao, it's wrong to get angry at the townspeople. I can't let go. Forte says, you must. It's the swing gang who made them do this. Rachel says, then what should we do? McBain says, we must talk to the townspeople face to face and tell them sincerely that we have nothing to do with the swing gang. Sincerely, says Forte. That's right, Una says. Forte, let's go back and talk to them. If we explain to them who we really are, they'll understand. Right, let's do it. Bruce says, I'll be waiting for you at the outdoor stage. I'll be praying that your sincerity will reach them. Wow. Any tips for us? I hope people will respond. We'll be happy to have even one person. Okay. I go around and talk to everybody again and try to convince them. Oops. Keith says, no. I said no. Carmi says, why are you so bullheaded, Mom? Call me whatever you want. Hey. What are you looking at? Are you members of the swing gang? Okay, I guess we can't talk to them yet. Una says, how can someone tear it up like that? Who did this? Rachel said. McBain says, I guess people here have much more hatred towards performers than I thought. I'm so mad, Rachel says. So mad. Oh, the music swells. Come on, fisherman, help us out. Oh! So you had your posters torn off? I'm sorry to hear that. You must be having a sense of injustice, being dragged into the mess left by the swing gang. It's just bad timing. You should give up. No, no giving up. No give up. Never, never, never. Oh. Could you please come and see our performance? I'm not interested. Wow. We can't blame them for tearing off the posters. You put them up without permission in the first place. Wow. What a stinker. Oh, so they tore off the posters? Because of the terrible acts of the swing gang, people are overreacting to performers. I don't suppose you have anything to say. Nope. Right. I care not that you are out of service. Oh, that kid we're supposed to talk to? So mad. Mad. We gotta talk to all of them. Okay. The bartender says, what is it? Would you like to come and listen to our performance? You can't do that. Don't promote your concert in the tavern. Oh, damn. I understand how you feel, but I don't want you to solicit audience in the tavern. Well, that's too damn bad. I'm gonna talk to them anyway. Are you giving a concert? That's right, says Uno. Una, will you come and listen to us? I'm sorry, but I can't. I don't want to fall into disfavor with people in this town. Please try others. I'm busy. Xiao says, please hear me out. Come and listen to our performance, will you? Don't do this. You know how we feel. We do, but we're begging you. I said no.
Jeez.
These people are hard asses. Oh, it's you guys. Una says, we're performing a new piece for the first time. Would you like to come and listen to it? I'm sorry, but I don't feel like it. You'd better get out of this town quickly. I don't think it's possible for you to perform in this town. There won't be any audience. Well, the kids were going to come, but now their mother won't let them out to play. There's no one in here. Una is not saying anything. It doesn't work. Why can't they understand? I'm so sad. Xiao says, da ha ha ha. Una, cheer up, will you? Cheese, smile. Look at my funny faces. Rachel says, what are you doing making funny faces? We don't have time to play around. I just wanted to make her smile. Una, you're a troubadour, Rachel says. Please be strong. If you're confident in your art, you should hold your chest out no matter what they say. That's going to make the men stare a lot. She's right, you know, says Xiao. See, I'm holding my stomach out, too. That's because you eat too much. Ha ha ha. But seriously, we might have some audience by now. Let's go back to Bruce. We might? I'll give you that idea. What? Would you like to come and listen to our performance? I hate music. You hate music? Thought he was following us. Alright. Did we go everywhere? Oh, wait. Let's see if anything at this one. So mad. Mad. Person in our way makes us even more mad. These people, right? I talked to them, right? Yeah. You've got to be kidding. Don't mention that in front of my wife. She is furious because the swing gang took away her secret savings. Yeah, he's back to that now. He was changed it to emotional stuff. Emotionally scarred or something. We can't even tell her no, we're not members of the swing gang. How do we have people? No one said yes. How do we have people? I don't understand that. Xiao telling us to go back. Alright, fine. We'll go talk to him. I wish there was another way into this house. Break through the window like the Kool-Aid man. Oh yeah! Come see our concert. How was it? Do you think we can get some audience? Forte says, we have no audience at all. No one said a word. Say something, Father, said Rachel. You're the joke cracker. Cheer us up. Even I can't think of anything funny. I've been an artist for a long time, but we always had our audience, large or small. Right, McBain? That's right. We're in the biggest fix of our career. If we can't perform again, we have no money to feed ourselves. We need to eat monsters. Rachel says, don't worry. Don't worry, what's wrong with performing without audience? I'll perform. If you don't want to, I'll do it by myself. Well, hopefully they'll gather. No, no, come on, we'll come with you. A voice says, brother! Huh? Says Forte. Is that one we helped? Called us brother after that? The kids? Oh, you! Oh, you! Carmi says, has the concert begun already? Weren't these the three kids that their mother wouldn't let us in the house? Not exactly, says Forte. Did you come to listen to us? Yes, says Koo. Carmi says, Mom was so stubborn, she kept saying no. It took me some time to sneak out of the house. But we're here now, says Lynn. Carmi says, I was really looking forward to this. You guys, says Xiao. Did you hear that, McBain? They were looking forward to this. McBain says, I must give them our best performance. You mean we must give them. All right, let's begin. McBain says, the McBain Company will play for you from our heart. The first piece is Open Your Mind, arranged by Bruce. It's a world premiere, so enjoy. The performance began in front of a handful of children. The small audience thoroughly enjoyed the performances of Forte and his friends. Bruce says, thank you very much, all of you. They think his name is Bruce Dickinson. He's about to tell us we need a little more cowbell. It was a wonderful performance. Your arrangement was great too, says McBain. Now you know what you can really do, how about starting training seriously to become a composer? How about you for some reason that whole sentence is so awkward. Haha, you overestimate me. I could do what I did because I had a great score. By the way, what will you do? We'll travel the road south and go to Viento. You may not be able to perform there either because of the swing gang. Then so be it. At least today's concert taught us that there are still people who want to listen to our performance. If we can find those people, however small in number, we want to perform for them. I wish you the best of luck. How about you, Xiao? Let's see. It sounds interesting, so we'll come with you, Master. McBain says, hey, don't decide by yourself. What's wrong? Says Rachel. You'll feel much younger traveling with a beautiful girl like me, Grandpa. I'm young enough, thank you. Bruce says, it seems like you'll have a fun journey ahead. I'll stay here a little longer and research the market on the negative impact of the swing gang. Research the market? You can do that? Once it's done, I'll return to the head office in Cavaro. I hope to produce your show someday. Good luck to you, Bruce, says Una. Thanks, Una. Please take care of yourselves. Goodbye, says Forte. I look forward to your great performance. Forward. Alright, before we leave, we'll check in with everybody again. Let's just look here, actually. Doll Knight 3 we have bought. Okay. So I want to make sure he didn't have any new stuff. I got a fever. And the only prescription is more cowbell. They say the swing gang showed up in Viento, so that's where they were headed. Just between you and I don't really hate concerts, but the situation we're in now... Yeah, go ahead. The swing gang reportedly did some damages in Viento. With the swing gang making all these headlines, there's no chance you can work. Well, Mr. Negativity here. Have you succeeded in gathering audience? McBain says, don't worry. We may not have had an audience in front of us, but we know our music reached them. We had an audience. Right, says Forte. The kids count. They count, dammit. If you're heading for Viento, be careful. You may run into the swing gang on your way. Tell me more. Or don't. I can't look at the bulletin boards anymore. Things have become unsafe in this world. When will they catch the swing gang? The hell should I know? Probably us be catching it. They say that the swing gang showed up in Viento. It's good that they went away from this town, but who knows? You can't be too careful. We're allowed in here now? I can't find my children. Where have they gone? They're so playful and always giving me trouble. Well, I think they went to an event. After that, couldn't say. Where's this person? Oh. I don't have anything, so I won't be the target of the swing gang. Or will I? Back to his fishing two line. Pardon me? I don't think this guy's gonna say anything new, but what the hell? Nope. Okay. I'm your fan. I'll be cheering you on. Your cithara was fantastic. I want to listen to it again. Just wait until you move. I'm your fan. Please come back to Trim. Well, in time, maybe. I mean, we haven't even left yet. Did I talk to him? Yeah, I did. I think. He's saying the same thing everyone else says anyway. Alright, so we have to head for Viento, which is 1,001 miles. Or milos, whatever. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.